Hello. In this video, we will study Dabigatran Etexilate, an oral direct thrombin inhibitor. First, we will understand the relevant physiology of coagulation, and then we will see Dabigatran in detail. Let's get started. First, relevant physiology. In video of coagulation, we have seen that after injury, multiple coagulation factors participate in coagulation cascade. One of them is thrombin. It converts fibrinogen into fibrin. The cascade is then continued and at the end clot is formed. Now let's bring in Dabigatran Etexilate. It is a prodrug and given in form of capsule. The capsule should be swallowed intact. Its oral bioavailability is low, about 6%. Dabigatran is a substrate for P-glycoprotein. It secretes some of the absorbed drug back into the lumen. Drugs like verapamil, amiodarone, etc. inhibit P-glycoprotein. So this back secretion is reduced and more Dabigatran enters the blood. So dose should be reduced in patients taking such drugs. Coming to blood. Here, inactive Dabigatran Etexilate is rapidly converted to active Dabigatran by plasma esterases. Now it inhibits active site of thrombin. So fibrin is not generated and as a result, coagulation is impaired. It is used for prevention of venous thromboembolism after hip or knee replacement surgery and prevention of embolism and stroke in patients with atrial fibrillation. Most important adverse event with Dabigatran is bleeding. This is due to impairment of coagulation. In case of excessive bleeding, a drug called idarucizumab can be used to reverse its action. It's basically monoclonal antibody directed against Dabigatran. It binds with Dabigatran with very high affinity. So effect of Dabigatran is prevented. Other side effect with Dabigatran is dyspepsia. So these were the side effects. Now let's finish remaining pharmacokinetics. Dabigatran is 35% plasma protein bound. Its peak action is seen after 2 hours of administration. Duration of action is 12 to 14 hours. Finally, 80% of the drug is excreted unchanged by kidneys. As kidney is the main route of excretion, its dose should be reduced in patients with severe renal impairment. Fixed dose of Dabigatran produces predictable anticoagulant response. So generally monitoring is not required with Dabigatran therapy. This is all about Dabigatran. Let's quickly revise some important points. Dabigatran is an oral direct thrombin inhibitor. It prevents clot formation. It's used for prevention of venous thromboembolism after knee or hip replacement surgery and for prevention of embolism and stroke in patients with atrial fibrillation. Most important adverse event is bleeding. Excessive bleeding by Dabigatran can be reversed by idarucizumab. Monitoring the therapy is usually not required with Dabigatran. That's it for this video. If you think this video will help your friends and colleagues, share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe Nonstop Neuron, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.